how to use Trello for project management in business and in your personal life. This video can be a breakthrough for you if you're looking for a very easy to apply solution that you can learn literally in 15 minutes and apply it to your business or your personal life and organize projects to become much more effective. This method is something that I designed that is very unique to Trello, so it's for beginners, but it's also for advanced users of Trello because I have not found even one video showing priorities assigned this way to tasks and different projects. I have shared this method with quite a few people now. Based on the feedback that they are giving me, I know it works and I know it can help you a lot. So all I'm asking for, give it a thought, look at the video. If you want, you can apply it. You can also share it with other people if you feel like this is something that somebody else can benefit from. But I know it's helping a lot of people. It has almost literally saved my life and it's just amazing. Towards the end of the video, I'm gonna also share part of my business board that I have on Trello. And keep in mind, this is fully customizable, so you can use it any way you want. You don't have to apply exactly the same way that I'm suggesting here, but the way that I'm suggesting and the structure that I'm showing you is working for a lot of people. So definitely give it a thought and let's see what happens. I wish you all the best and let's get started. And there are different lists that you can see, and under each list, we're going to be putting different projects and tasks and things to do. The way that I organized it is based on a modified Moscow method, and that's a different video, and you can Google Moscow method. Should do is a list of things that you should do. Must do is a list, obviously, of things that you must do. Doing is going to be very important because as you are doing certain things, you will be able to see what is currently pending and what you have started, but it's not completed yet. And done is something that already has been completed. You will also see two other lists here, and that is going to be a could do, not necessarily a should, but you know, you would like to do certain things, and that's a could do. And there will be some things that are not a to do yet, but a very good idea for the future. And that's what I put here under ideas for the future. A very important list as well. You also have organization, and organization I use for so many things that you will have to come back to. And it could be things that you want to copy and paste later on. It could be your logo, could be your business plan, your list of goals, and things that you don't want to just have in so many different places. If you want to keep it in one place, you would put it under organization tab. I also put priorities here, and we're going to come back to this one in a quick second, because it's important for me to, when I set it up for people, so they can come back in case they forget how the priorities work. And then you can put a card. I put Polisher Business Support. In case they need support, they can always give me a call. So let's get started and let's put this beautiful machine to work. Let's put a should do task, and we will call it should do task number one. Okay, and we can correct that should do to should do. Okay, so now we have a task. As we have this task here, keep in mind that a should do task can become a must do, and you can just move it to must do. The same task, when you start it, you can move it to done, to doing, and when it's done, you can move it to done. I actually don't like the name should do task, so let's just call it task one. Okay, so as task one is sitting here under should do, we may want to assign a priority, and that priority, I suggest we can use one of these categories. So some things are going to be urgent and important at the same time. Some things are going to be urgent, but a little bit less important. Like somebody gives you a deal that is only until Tuesday, but you don't even know if you're interested in the deal. So that would be an example of an urgent, less important task. You have things that are not urgent, but very important, like writing a strategic plan. And you will have non-urgent and less important. And those are the things that shouldn't be here, but sometimes they may get to your to-do list. if I set this one up for my clients, you as a client, you will see another color here, and that is needs owner's attention. So you don't have to look at all the tasks, you would only look at the blue. But let's say you're using this one only for yourself, okay? Now your should-do task number one, you decide that it's an urgent, important task. So you just click on the task, you click on labels, you click on urgent, important, and as this label becomes visible, you click out and you can see that it's red. In case you forget, you can click on it and then you will see what the color means. That task may have different checklists that you want to put under this specific task. And let's call this checklist just a checklist. You can change the name. And then you may have things to do, and that's going to be thing number one, thing number two, number three. Okay. And when I click out of it, you will see that the task has now 0 out of 3 done. Let's say we start doing this task already. We move it to doing. And let's say we already have done number one and number two. Then you will be able to see that you have completed 2 out of 3. Very cool. Maybe you would like to put an attachment here. It could be a file, a PDF, or it could be a screenshot. Let's say I want to take a screenshot of this specific task. So what I'm going to do is just quickly take a screenshot of this one. And I want to show you how easily you will be able to copy and paste an image here. And as it gets pasted and you get out of the task, you can see an image that is already attached, which you can still move as part of the card. If you have a lot of tasks here, which I'm going to show you in a second how it's going to look like later, then you most likely don't want to have too many images here. So you can still keep the image here as an attachment, but you can, what we call it, remove cover. When you remove the cover, image is still here, but it's not displayed as a preview. Now, here is a very cool thing. Let's say you have multiple people and you use this to manage a strategy. And those multiple people will be communicating through Trello, and you want to be able to oversee everything that is happening. You will assign members. So when you click on the task, you will see members here. Just above labels, you have members. I have only one here, but you may have multiple. And then on this specific one, I'm going to assign Mike. Okay. And if I had more, I could assign multiple people. If I have a question about that specific task that Mike is doing, what I will do is just go to activity and write a comment. I can tag Mike, so he will get notified, and I will say, what is the status of this one? All you have to do is click save. Now, here's the cool thing. Once this comment is here under the card, it gets sent to Mike because he was tagged here and he agreed to have notifications. And Mike receives an email, but he doesn't have to even log into Trello, even though it works on mobile devices, it works on a PC, it works on a Mac, the same exact way or very similar way. But he doesn't even have to log in. All he has to do is reply to the email, and the reply will be coming back to the chat right here. And for you to supervise something like this, all you have to do is click on this and you will have a history of all the communication here. Let's say because the task is urgent, there is a deadline. So under members, under labels, under check sheet, you or checklist, you can select a due date. Let's say it's for Friday. And that is going to be for 2 p.m. So we're going to save it. And now the card has a due date for November 29th. If the card is completed, you can just complete the third item on the check sheet. And by the way, you can have multiple check sheets here. And you can also complete here to show the task as complete. And once the task is fully ready to be moved to done, you have a couple of options. You can either move it to done, or you can click move and select done. Or I also created what's called the Power Apps. I also create some shortcuts on Trello. So within one click, you can just click move to done and it gets moved to done. And then you can go and create another task. Maybe it's going to be a must do and call it number task. You call it task number two. You can have task number three. And you can have so many different things going on here, but keeping it organized. I think you're going to love it. Ideas for the future is going to be very important, because as some of the things are not tasks to do yet, there may be ideas that you don't want to forget about. What I actually did before is I put here meet Tony Robbins. And true story, I put meet Tony Robbins here. And then a few short weeks, I don't even think it was months, a few short weeks later, I actually met him. So how you word it, first of all, law of attraction, if you believe in it, is going to work for you if you put certain things under ideas for the future and just write them down, even if they're not tasks yet, because you can always make it a task later on. But the interesting thing is what you put here, I would just pay attention how you write it, because if this really works like that, if I put work with Tony Robbins, I probably would be working with him right now. And because I put meet with Tony Robbins, I only met him. I was able to meet my guru. But at the same time, it's a lessons learned, because what you put here matters. And it really matters to write it down, and it matters how you write it. What I would like to show you here that is going to be interesting is I would like to show you a board that may be a good example for you how it's going to look like. I'm not going to show you everything, but this is my board that is much more elaborated and advanced, but it's going to look kind of like this. You can have multiple different lists here, or you can put shortcuts here. So if I want to invite somebody to like my page through Messenger, all I have to do is just copy this and paste it, and that's it, and paste it in the Messenger. I don't have to write it down. If I want to look at hashtags, I have the whole list of hashtags for Instagram right here under this board, which is also very, very useful. You can have different goals, you can have check sheets, and I don't want to show too much of what I'm doing, but you can have your sales process here, key questions for the initial consultation, your goals, and I have multiple check sheets and goals for weekly, daily, and all that stuff. So I just wanted to show you that there is a multiple different ways you can use this simple board and make it as complicated as you want, but at the same time keeping very simple structure, saving a lot of time, and you will be able to accomplish so much more, because as you are assigning priorities, I suggest make all the strategic projects important, even if they're not urgent, so you will know that whatever is red or yellow is related to your strategy. It does have a long-term impact because it's important. And those are the things you must make sure that they get done. Other colors, if there is something that is here and happens to be non-urgent and less important, what you try to do, as I wrote it here, you try to either drop it or delegate it, but those are not the most important. This specific system that I designed here, I think is going to save you a lot of time. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions, if you like it, if you would like me to set it up for you. If that was set up for you as a client, you will be able to manage the whole campaign and see every single moment of the day, what has been done, by whom, and how much, what is planned, what are the priorities. It just gives you peace of mind as a business owner. If you do this for yourself, you will be able to have multiple different boards for multiple different things if you want. If not, one main one for home, one main one for business. It will save you tremendous amount of time. I wish you all the best, and I wish you the best productivity, because productive people achieve more. When we achieve more, we are able to help more people, improve more lives. I'm extremely passionate about it, but it's not easy to do it when we only have 24 hours. So this is one of the tools that was very helpful for me. And when I had feedback from other people who started using it, that they love it, I felt like it's a good idea to share with you. Give me comments below. Give this video a like if you like it. Let me know your feedback. If you have any questions, when you leave a comment, I'm going to reply and I'll be very happy to help you. Thanks so much. Take care.